If you are feeling unhappy, stressed, unappreciated, or burnt out, it's a very real feeling. If you feel unhappy in your relationship or at your work, it is your responsibility to take the action to communicate with the people involved. If you choose to say nothing, it'll be a downward spiral of negativity because most things don't magically solve themselves. Sometimes we try to communicate, but we think it doesn't work, so we stop trying. But instead of giving up, we can build our communication skills. When a problem arises, it's no one's fault. It's not your fault, so don't blame yourself. And it's not the other person's fault, so don't blame them. When we clash with someone, it's for a variety of reasons, like different beliefs, different principles, different values, causing our dynamics and circumstances to be difficult. Understanding this helps put us in the right mindset before we start to communicate. If we start the communication process filled with righteous anger, we'll carry resentment and judgment into the conversation. This will cause us to be defensive and to take things very personally, and we'll be triggered when the person says things we don't like to hear or don't agree with. Getting impatient, frustrated, or upset when communicating is normal because we all have insecurities and fears that trigger us. What can help us, however, is to be aware of when our emotions are rising so that we don't just react without thinking. This is why it's important that before we even start talking to someone, we have to be mentally prepared to have no expectations of how the person should respond to us. Ideally, when we're talking to someone about something so important to us, we would like for the person to respond appreciatively or maturely. However, the person may very well respond argumentatively or defensively, and we have to remind ourselves to not take it personally. Not taking things personally doesn't mean we agree with what the person is saying. It just means that we ourselves are not triggered to react badly when they say something we don't agree with. When we communicate our vulnerabilities, it's normal that the person doesn't immediately understand it. It's already so hard for us to understand ourselves, much less having someone understand us immediately. When we try to communicate our stress, discontentment, and unhappiness, the objective is not for people to agree with us or for us to be right. The objective is for us to have a better understanding so that we can figure out how to solve the challenges that we're facing. Our partner may love us and our employer may be responsible for us, but our happiness is and always will be our own responsibility. This is why one of the best things we can do for ourselves is to develop the skills to communicate and to solve problems positively so that we can truly be happy always.